Hello everyone, this is Sushila Challamuthu, your online tutor. In this session, I am going to explain how to give the input through the command line in Java. You see the example, then you can understand clearly. So this is a program for giving the input through the command line. First, we have to include the header files, that is import java.io.star. So here, what are the input functions we are using inside the program? We need a package to include here. So that's why you have to include import java.io.star. Then one more header files here included because we are handling the string. Here in Java program, consider everything as a string. So we have to include the package import java.language.string. Okay, as it is, we have to start the program public class name test1, already is created in BlueJ environment. Now we are going to see the program in step by step. Here as it is, public static void main. Here string, we are going to handle the string, that's why you have to give the default statement string. Here we are going to give the input through the command line arguments, so that's why here we have to mention argument ES of vector. Okay, this is array vector. Here we are going to store the value what are through this arguments ES of. Here this is called array. We are going to give the input through the command line. That input will be stored here, like arguments of 0, arguments of 1, like that. So this is a array. Whatever we are going to give the input through the command line, that input will be stored here. That is called arguments of S. So it is nothing but a array. How the array will work? It will start from 0, array of 0, array of 1, like that. The same thing here, it will start arguments of 0, arguments of 1. So after running the program, you can understand what is the use for that. Then inside the program, as it is, we have to declare the number 1, number 2, sum. We are going to store the value here. This is a printf statement, that is a, we are going to display the addition in the monitor. Then as it is, here whatever we are giving through the input as well as command line argument, everything considers a string. So we have to convert string into integer. So this is a default syntax for conversion purpose, that is string to integer. That's why we need to give here integer dot parse int of arguments of 0. Suppose we are going to give the two values. So first value stored in arguments of 0, then second value stored in arguments of 1. So that's why. So we need to convert the two values. It will store in number 1 and number 2, then add the two values, then finally print the result. Okay. Now, so there is no, after compiling this, there is no error. Then you see the environment. Here you go it. Then just right click it. It will open it. Here you have to give the two values. Yes, 200, just I am giving. You have to give within your quote, then 400. Yeah, just click it, okay. Then you see the result. Yeah, so program name is addition, the sum of new number is 600. So this is your printf statement, whatever you want, you give it. Okay, suppose you are giving Q command, automatically quit the environment. Here, suppose again you are going to run the program, the same result will be displayed here. So that's why you have to clear it. After getting the result, you have to clear it. Okay. So this is a way of giving the input through the command line. Here, one more time I will run. Yes. Here within your code you have to give value 200, then comma 200. You check the result. Yeah, 200. Again, you have to check the different input. So this is one way of giving the input. The five value, the first five is stored in arguments s of 0, second one is stored in arguments of s of 1. So now check the result. The answer is 10. So likewise we have to run the program. So once again I repeat this. Yeah, we have to include the header files, then create the class name. Within your main function you have to write the code. Here we need to declare the variable, what are the variable we are going to use in our program. Then here the conversion purpose, we have to use the command integer dot parseInt. So already I mentioned Java is case sensitive, so we have to give the same syntax like that. Suppose if you are giving instead of small p, you are giving the caps p, definitely the error will come. Okay, so again you compile it, so there is no error, then you will run the program. Suppose you have to give the float values, you have to check the float values, you need to check the float values, you can change here, and here we can convert this. Okay, thank you. I think you can understand how to give the input through the command line. Once again, thank you so much.